You might have noticed that I'm in a new location, but in reality, I haven't moved at all. This change of scene is the magic of editing. And if I wanted to change my set, I could do just like that or that, or maybe go to New York. We're using a green screen behind me to change the background. In this video, I'm going to show you how to use the Chroma Key and remove background tools in CapCut to achieve this result. Let's dive in.
As I already mentioned, there are two ways in which you can approach this effect. One is with the use of a green screen. A green screen is a bright green backdrop used in video production. We use green because it's distinct from most clothing and skin tones, making it easier to isolate. By replacing the green color in post-production, we can transport our video to anywhere we imagine. Chroma keying is the technique of making a particular color, like our green screen, transparent. This process allows us to overlay different backgrounds. It's a staple in news broadcasting for weather segments and in movie for creating fantastical environments. But just to be clear, this would work with any solid color. It's not just exclusive to green. Just remember that it has to be a different color from your subject to avoid removing more than what's intended. For a successful green screen effect, proper lighting is key. It needs to be evenly distributed to avoid shadows. Also, ensure your green screen is wrinkle-free and placed at a good distance from the subject to prevent color spill, which is what happens when the green gets reflected onto your subject, creating problems for the editing software when separating the elements. Now I want to show you how to recreate the intro that you saw at the beginning of this video in CapCut. So let's dive in. We're gonna start a new project, and then we're gonna tap on the green screen video that we have right here. We're gonna add it. Now we need to import our fake background. So we're gonna tap on the plus icon, and then we're gonna go in photos, and here we're gonna pick this one as the first one. Then we're gonna tap on add. Now I have to put the green screen clip as an overlay. So we're gonna tap on it, then we're gonna scroll in the menu until we see overlay. Then we need to make the image that we're gonna use as a background as long as the overall clip. So let's have it until here for now. And then we're gonna tap on the green screen clip. Then we're gonna go in the menu that is called Remove BG, Remove Background. We're gonna tap on it. And now let's tap on Chroma Key. Then we can move the color picker where the green is. Then you're just gonna release your finger. We're gonna tap on Intensity, and we're gonna increase the intensity of the effect. And there you go, just like magic, the green disappeared. Then now if we play back the sequence, we can see that yes, the green is not there anymore, but if you notice on my black t-shirt, we can see some white dots appearing here and there. And to solve this, we are just gonna have to bring the shadow slider that we saw next to the intensity a little bit up. So let's do that. We're gonna tap again on the green screen. We're gonna tap on remove background. We're gonna tap on chroma key, and then we're gonna go in shadow. Here we'll have to drag the slider towards the right to make sure that we bring back those black colors in my t-shirt. And that's it. Now, if you play again the sequence, you see that my t-shirt is completely black. So we don't have those white dots anymore. Now, as you can see, we're showing what's underneath the main green screen clip. And we can see that we have the image of the house that we just imported before. But then we have also a black bar in the top because the image is not covering the overall screen. So we can simply drag that image up to cover that black bar. And there you go. Now it looks absolutely perfect. And as you saw in the intro, in a certain point, I snapped the fingers and I changed location. So let's do that. We're gonna just try to find the point where I do that. That's it. Then we're gonna split our background image. We're gonna delete the ending, and we're gonna import a different image. So we're gonna try to use this desert photo. We're gonna import it, and just like that, it changes. Bam. Once again, we just need to adjust the position. So we're gonna bring it upward like that. That's perfect. And then we can make it as long as the second snapping finger. So we're gonna position our playhead right in the exact position. And then we're gonna split this background photo. We're gonna delete it, and then we're gonna add something else. Let's pick this one, for example. We're gonna add it. And then even in this case, you just need to resize it like we always do with any other clip or image. So with two fingers, you're just gonna pinch out until we manage to cover the overall background. That's it. And now if we look at it back,
just like that, or that.
That's it, that's perfect. Maybe we can anticipate this transition, so we're just gonna drag this one a little bit towards the left to have it shorter.
Or that.
Yeah, maybe now this one is a little bit too delayed, so we're just gonna make it longer.
Or that.
That's it. And when I say go to New York, we can add a photo of New York as well. So let's understand where exactly is that point.
Or maybe go to New York.
There you go. And then we can split this background, delete it, and then add a different image, the one from New York. There you go. And then we're gonna drag it at the very top of our frame. Okay, maybe we can make it slightly bigger so that we show better the buildings. And I think this should work. Potentially, I can anticipate the transition a tiny bit so that it matches when I say New York. And to make it even more appealing, we can add a transition. Maybe we can use right or left. Let's tap on the transition. Then we're gonna go into camera, and then we're gonna find the movement that we want to use. So we're probably gonna use this one. Cool, and that is perfect. And then next I say, we're using a green screen. So in that moment, I want to go back to using this green screen normally without showing any fake background.
We're using a green
screen. So right here, we're gonna trim this background image. Then we're gonna go again into our main clip. We're gonna split it. We're going to put this one back in the main track. Tap on main track. And now we should be good to go. Let's double check the overall sequence from this point onwards.
I could do just like that or that, or maybe go to New York. We're using a green screen behind me to change the background.
That's it, that's perfect. The other way to achieve this effect is using the auto removal tool in CapCut, which is an automated feature that removes the background automatically, regardless of the color or the elements in it, as long as you have a clear subject. This is ideal for quick edits when you don't have a green screen. Let me show you how this works. So let's start a new project, and then we're gonna go in videos, and then we're gonna select this clip right here, then this one, and this one. We're gonna tap on add. So we're gonna tap on the first one, we're gonna select the part that we wanna use, for example, from here, and then we're gonna trim after, yeah, probably here, let's say. Then we're gonna select this clip, we're gonna go in remove background, and then we need to tap on auto removal. Here, CapCut will analyze the clip that we have and is gonna try to identify a subject and cut out that subject from the remaining part of the clip. So we're gonna tap on the check mark. And now, as you can see, we removed the background even though it didn't have a solid color or a green screen. So now let's try to build this little sequence where every time I clap, I change location. So we're gonna move the playhead until I clap the first time here. And then we're gonna split the clip right here. And we're gonna put the second part as an overlay. So we're gonna drag the menu until we see overlay. That's it. Then I want to reset the auto removal here because I wanna keep the original background as a first clip. So we're just gonna go in remove background, and then we're gonna go in auto removal, and we're gonna restore. There you go. Now you tap on the check mark. And then we can move on when I clap the second time right here. And then I can split and delete the ending of the first background to have the third one appearing. There you go. And then let's do again one more time. When I clap again, I'm just gonna split and delete. And there you go. And we have another background coming in. And that is wonderful. We can split it right here. Before I start clapping for the fourth time, we're gonna split this background and finish off the sequence right here. Once again, let's try to be precise when we finish a video. That's it. One more thing that I can do to match better these backgrounds is maybe to adjust the exposure and the white balance if needed. I can see that this one, for example, is a little bit too dark comparing to me, compared to the subject in front. So we're gonna tap on this one, we're gonna go in adjust, and then we're gonna increase the brightness of the background clip, which is actually an image. And I think this looks awesome. Then we're probably gonna do the same thing with this one. We're just gonna increase the exposure a tiny bit. Gonna go in adjust brightness and then increase it. I think this should be fine. And let's double check the last one. I think the last one looks good. If I wanna do something maybe better, I can try to increase the dimension, the size of the background image, and then change the rotation just a tiny bit to straighten it up. And that's perfect. Obviously, I can mute the clips and then add a different music if I want to. Let's add, for example, any music from CapCut. This one, I like it. Then we're gonna drag it at the beginning, and then we're just gonna split here so that we have an ending that matches the end of our clips as well. Then we're gonna fade in and fade out, and this is the final result. Now, you will notice a difference between the two methods. As convenient as the auto background removal sounds, the cutout is not always perfect. If there is a lot of movement, or if your subject has accessories such as a hat or sunglasses, CapCut might cut some of those elements out. So green screens, when used correctly, offer precise control and generally higher quality results, but also require careful setup and additional gear when filming. Auto removal tools, on the other hand, are fast and convenient, but might struggle with complex backgrounds or detailed edges. There are many situations in which using these tools could come in handy. I've just shown you two options in which we modified the background to make our video more eye-catching, but you don't always have to use it for this. Remember, these are tools that are meant to expand your creative capabilities, and sometimes the main use for which they were created is not the only one that you should use. Now I want to show you other creative applications using this tool. So we're going to create a new project and we're gonna import this video right here. Let's see the original video now. We see this colorful background, this beautiful lady in the front, and then we have a slow motion effect. What I wanna try to do here, I wanna try to have a background change from black and white to color. To do this, we'll have to select the clip and then duplicate it first. Then we're gonna bring the copy as an overlay. We're gonna drag it at the very beginning so that we have two matching clips, top and bottom. Now we're gonna remove the background from the overlay. So you're gonna tap on it, then you're gonna go into remove background and then auto removal. It will look like that nothing happened, but this is because we have two clips that look exactly the same on top of each other. So now we can play around creatively with the bottom clip. So for example, now I wanna make a transition from black and white to color in the background only. So what I'm gonna do is that I'm gonna select a point where the colors will be fully black, and probably it's gonna be like here. Then we add a keyframe. Now we're gonna go at the beginning of the clip, let's say right here, and then we're gonna change the saturation to zero. So we're gonna tap on adjust, and then we're gonna bring the saturation to zero. Now, as you can see, we changed the color of the background only. The subject is still in color because it's our top layer, is the one that we use to remove the background. Then we tap on the check mark, and now let's rewatch together the transition. We start with black and white, and then when the slow motion starts, we're gonna start bringing back the colors until they're fully there. Now I want to show you another way for a creative use of auto removal. And this is simulating a cinematic mode in a clip that was shot not in cinematic mode. Now let's go back to the main menu and let's go in effects. Now we're gonna tap on video effects, then we're gonna go to lens, and then we're gonna look for blur. We're gonna tap on it, then we can tap on adjust if we want to decrease the blur amount. I think this is a little bit too much, looks a little bit fake, so we're just gonna decrease it until probably like that. I think 16 looks already good. Then if you're happy with the result, you're gonna tap on the check mark, and now we can make this effect element as long as the overall clip. In case this cinematic mode was applied also to the overlay clip that you had there, you can go into object and here you'll be able to select where to apply that effect. So for example, if I tap on overlay, you'll see that the overlay one, so the one that we have only the subject in it, is gonna be blurred and the background is not gonna be blurred. So again, let's tap on object and let's select main video. And now we can review the overall sequence. And as you can see, we simulated cinematic mode in a normal clip. As we conclude today's journey through the advanced world of Chroma Key and remove background tools, remember that the skills you've learned are powerful additions to your video editing toolkit. These techniques are about enhancing your videos, solving editing challenges, and unleashing your creative potential. Go ahead, experiment with different backgrounds, play with colors, and see how you can transform your footage. Your skills in video editing are constantly evolving, and these tools are just elements you can add to your project. So keep honing your skills, and remember, the key to improving your video editing is practice, patience, and creativity. I'll see you in the next video. This video gave you a sneak peek into what our iPhone Video Editing Academy has in store. Delve deeper into mastering advanced video editing techniques, from initial cuts in the Photos app to creating sophisticated scenes in CapCut. Whether you are a beginner or looking to up your video editing game, this course equips you with everything you need to make your project stand out. Join me as we explore the art of video editing, ensuring your content captures the essence of your creativity. Are you ready to elevate your editing skills? Check out the full course through the link.